that there are things we don't need to compete on. And basic infrastructure, large, small, big, you know, and so on. If we have basic infrastructure first, you save economies of scale, you don't have to duplicate spending, but it enables you to save that money and actually focus on the core of financial services.
The fourth annual Bankers Conference is being held at a time of unprecedented challenges facing the financial sector. COVID-19 pandemic and technological advancements are cited among major catalysts of tech innovations in the financial sector.
The financial services sector plays a huge role, especially because finance, money drives the world, pretty much. The telecom sector and internet service sector drives connectivity. With money becoming more virtual, more mobile, more online, then you find that telecom sector and the financial services sector can't operate without each other. Then, of course, there's ancillary sectors that come along.
This year's event focuses on the fourth industrial evolution. 4IR is mainly characterized by the fusion of the digital, biological, and physical worlds, as well as the growing utilization of new technologies such as artificial intelligence, cloud computing, and advanced wireless technologies. While new tech offers convenience and reliability in service delivery, concerns are raised on its negative impact on employment in the banking sector. As computers continue to eat into human resource space, the question to ponder on is, what is the future of work?
Think outside. It's not even think outside the box anymore. Think outside the building. That's what it means. That today more than ever, what else can I use to survive? What innovations can I do in these times? And this is where technology comes. So yes, it may appear that efficiencies brought about by technology could take away jobs, but they in turn open opportunities.
These digital solutions provide not just access to the account, but it also offers payment solutions for these consumers, hence creating a platform that allows them to use that account for other services. And as such, indeed, we've seen that on a trend-wise basis, that the level of dormancy indeed will reduce as access points increase.
Improvements in Uganda's and generally Africa's ICT sector have been largely driven by expanding mobile digital financial services. However, the continent still lags behind in several indicators essential for a successful digital revolution, and this includes development of physical and digital infrastructure, lack of electricity, low tele-density, broadband penetration, and internet density, among others. Dennis Igoa for UBC Business.